This is CD 1. This program is entitled Consciousness, Aging, and the New Millennium with Ram Dass at the Millennium Conference 1996, held at the Metaphysical Center of New Jersey.
Good afternoon. Can you all hear in the back? Can you hear in the back? Yeah, good. Thank you, Alice, for setting me up as a loving soul. Get a lot of mileage off that. Why not? Because all the labels of us aren't really labeling who we are anyway. You notice that? Somebody says, I'm a mother. Think of all the things you are more than besides being a mother. You know, you're somebody who goes to the bathroom. Why don't you define yourself that way? You know. If you didn't, you would. Yesterday afternoon, Dan was showing you what he does, and he stood on his head. This is what I do. Just want to get my credentials straight. Actually, I play golf, which surprises people, because do great souls play golf? And why would they play golf? Well, I find it a very interesting meditation practice. I get out in nature, so I take a walk in nature, then I stop and I do a practice, then I take a walk, I stop, I do a practice. The practice is shooting the golf ball. So while every afternoon that I go out, since it's the middle of the week in the afternoon, I always end up being paired off with three retired Republicans. Which is great, because you never talk about anything. I mean, I become Dick. Hi, I'm Dick. Great clubs you got there. But it's interesting because they think I'm playing golf. Well, actually, I'm meditating. Can you see how my mind defines the reality a different way than their mind defines the reality? Like, I got assigned to one guy a few months ago. And by the second hole, he had already cursed, screamed, thrown his club. Absolutely, he was really angry. And after our drive on the second hole, I turned to him and I said, are you having fun? Sort of a no-no in golf, but you having fun? And he looked furious at me and he said, yes. I said, great, as long as you're enjoying yourself. Because it was so obvious that golf was a game to be delighted in. It's such an irresponsible use of land and everything. You might as well enjoy it if you're going to. So then it turned out there was a book that came out many years ago by Mike Murphy called Golf and the Kingdom, sort of a mystical book about golf, like Zen and the Art of Motorcycle Riding, things like that, you know, and archery and stuff like that. It was, Mike described going to Scotland and meeting a mystical player named Shivas Irons in the middle of the night who taught him how to play golf with his eyes closed and all that kind of stuff. And so there turned out to be a Shivas Irons Society, which was a society for sort of mystic golfers. So I gave a keynote there last year. Now I blurb golf books. It's far out. See, now I just tried on that identity and suddenly here I am, a golf. People are giving the tape to their friends. And it's all about how you turn golf into a meditation practice. Now, what I'm talking about is taking something for which you have certain cultural stereotypic responses to, about golf, for example. Now, I'm not saying it's negative or anything. You just have them. You have some. You know the way the culture views golf. And then I'm showing you the way I'm taking that experience and I'm using it in a certain way in my consciousness to transform my consciousness. In other words, I'm using my life experiences as vehicles through which I can awaken spiritually into other levels of awareness. Now, before we go any further, we've all got to go along together. So if you don't understand what I'm talking about, you have a responsibility to yourself and to the rest of us to just raise your hand. And then I will clarify as best I can, okay? So how many now would like to raise their hand? Okay. There are, I think, about 5 hands. Many of you drive cars. Drive automobile? Do you drive an automobile? And you can drive an automobile these days, probably if you've been driving for a while. You can drive an automobile so that you are literally hurtling through space in about, nowadays, about 3,000 pounds of metal and plastic. You're making incredible decisions about centrifugal and centripetal force, about rates of acceleration and deceleration. It would take a whole board, a blackboard, to put on all the stuff that you're going through in you. And generally during that time, you're tuning the radio, looking for police, planning where you're going, remembering where you've been. And very little, if I stopped you at that moment in the car and said to you, who are you? Probably you wouldn't say a driver. And yet there you are making this incredibly complex set of mechanics. Is that, you hear that one? So what I could say is in that situation, you are already seeing yourself functioning on two levels. There's what's called the base brain level, where you're driving the car now. And then there is the cognitive level, where you're thinking about planning, remembering, doing something. Is that, we all here together now? Now, what life is, in terms of the experiences of life, the romanticism of life, the romantic storyline, the as the world turns kind of life. Is that familiar? Okay. I never know which a cultural, as the world turns level. That's the level in which you and I have bodies, and we move around, and we have relationships, and we have thinking apparatus, and we have sensing apparatus. That's all a plane of reality in which most people live on. In that case, you and I are in New Jersey. We met in New Jersey that day. Little did we expect. Now, that's a little bit like where you drive the car. Now there's another level here where you are a psychological social entity. We could do this like if you had television channel receptors by your eyeball. So you tune to channel 1 and you look at me and you see a 65-year-old, gently decaying, handsome gentleman. Okay. That's the physical take. Now shift a channel. Now you look up and you see a lecturer, you see a Caucasian, you see a wise-looking, wise, kind, compassionate being, neurotic. You see all that. You see my...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.